Okay, in this session we are going to discuss CPLD, complex. CPLD means complex programmable device. Okay, but here in this CPLD architecture, the blocks are defined here, IBIO block, PLI blocks, total here, total 4 blocks we are using in this architecture. IBIO blocks, PA, programmable array logic like blocks, we are using 4 blocks, and this each block connecting IBIO block and interconnection of the wires. But here the simple operation, input data sent to the IBIO block, from IBIO block data will be distributed to respective PL blocks through the switching connections. Similarly, the data will be generated, data will be sent to the IBIO block through the switching connection. This is the simple operation of CPLD. But here in this CPLD, the PL-like blocks are, each PL function has 16 macro cells. But here total how many blocks here, PL-like blocks, 1, 2, 3, 3 and 4, total 4 blocks like PL-like structures, but each block having the 16 macro cells. But in this, this is the 16, first PL having 16 macro cells and second PL having 16 macro cells and the third PL having 16 macro cells and PL, fourth PL having 16 macro cells. But here total how many here, 16 plus 16, and total 16 plus 16, 16 into 4 equal to total 64 PL like blocks. But similarly here each macro cell access to 16 signals from IBIO block. But in this PL like structure, each macro cell having total 16 input by output signals, means total 16 by output signals means 16 into 16, total 256, 256 into 4 PL blocks, that is nothing but 1024 signal lines from IBIO block. This is the CPLD architecture, simple operation. But let us see the internal structure of PL-like block. This is the simple macro cell, PL-like block architecture, simple macro cell. Already we discussed in previous last session, what is the PL and what is the PL and what is the PLA and what is the PROM. But here in this CPLD architecture, the reprogramming of the PL structure here, this is the PL structure. Output of the PL structure we are connecting using this flip-flap and MUX. Here the selection of the MUX 0 means it is connected directly the output of the PL structure, that is the, it is nothing but combinational circuit. Similarly, the output of the MUX generated through the flip-flap, through the flip-flap means it is a D flip-flap, means it is connected to the MUX, the selection lines must be, the selection line must be 1. This is the operation of simple macro cell operation, right? Here in this macro cell, this is the only one macro cell, but here this PLA like structures were having total 16 macro cells like this, these structures. Means this type of macro cell block diagrams here, total in this block 16 macro cells we are using here. 16 macro cells and 16, total 64 macro, 64 blocks we are using, 64 macro cell blocks we are using here. This is the simple operation for logic implementation using macro cell. You implement the boolean function y equal to a dot b whole bar. This is the NAND operation function. Sigma m equal to 0 comma 1 comma 2. But here the problem is given y equal to a dot b whole bar. Right? You can implement here this first one macro cell. What, how many inputs here? Variables here a and b. You can represent here a b, inverting and non-inverting. And you can connect the AND gate just like it is a PL structure. AND gate. And AND gate connect, output of the AND gate you can connect the vertical using the OR gate. And what is the OR gate function here? The programming, the programming of this one, y equal to a dot b. Y equal to a dot b means you can program here. Similarly, what we have discussed in previous session, PLA and PL, here also same programming. But the operation of here, this is the PLA structure. The operation of PL, what is the definition says? The programming and array programming and R array is fixed. Here also same operation, you can observe here a dot b. And what is the a dot b? You can represent here a dot b. You can connect the OR gate of this one. And what is the final expression for this XOR output? That is nothing but y bar. But here the given expression y equal to a dot b. But here the observe the output of the observation, you can observe the y bar. Y bar means you can use the XOR gate. For why you are using here XOR gate means it is a complement, or you can true form, you can change it here the programming. But here the Y bar, you can select here using this operation, AND operation. The T is nothing but true value and C is nothing but complement value. Why here presenting T equal to complement means both zeros, means this is the output should be the 00 and 11. That's why you can take it as a T equal to 0. Next, C means here, C means complement. The input function of the C is 0. The output of the binary values represent here complement. That's why here you can represent 1 is nothing but complement, 0 is nothing but true form using this NAND operation, truth table. Similarly, you can connect here the output of the OR gate Y bar. The Y bar is nothing but here, what is the original expression given? Y, Y equal to A dot B whole bar. But here the original OR gate function Y bar. Y bar means you can complement here. What is the value you have taken? Complement means 1. The XOR input, the programming should be the 1. Right? 1 means the programming means what is the output of the XOR operation. You can represent here Y. Y means you can select the complement form means Y bar, the complement Y. Right? Here in this XOR operation, the Y function, it can generate to non-register. Non-register means the selection line 0 means it can mux select directly the combinational circuit. The selection line 1 means the flip-flop, it can operate. The output function, you can observe the Y equal to A dot B. Similarly, you can observe the truth table for this expression. A, B, you can give apply the A, B. The clock should be the 0. The clock should be the 0 while you are operating this macro cell. The clock should be the 0 and non-written, non-register operation should be the as usual the output of the function, and Y and non-written same. Next, register operation. This register, when the clock 0 means the register operation should be undefined function. It is not generate the any values, undefined. Next, the selection line should be the 0. This is the selection line 0 means the operation of the combinational circuit like this. The non-written operation perform like this. Similarly, you can observe the output of the NAND gate 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 0. This is the operation of the NAND gate. For this is the truth table meant for combinational circuit. You can observe the sequential circuit. Similarly, same operation here, A, B given the 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0. The clock should be the, while you are using the sequential circuit, the clock must be 1, otherwise it is not operate, right? While you are putting the clock 0 means the D flip flop should be the not working. While you are connecting the clock 1 means the perform the sequential operation. 0 means the perform the combinational operation. Here A, B and clock should be the 1, and non-written as usual the output of the function directly it goes to the non-written operation, but it not operate. A register operation, when the clock equal to 1, the register operation, this operation perform the NAND operation. Similarly, the selection line should be the 1. This is the selection line. Mux selection line should be the 1. Means here you can put the 1 and clock should be the 1. The operation of the sequential circuit, that is the Y equal to A dot B bar. This is the simple operation of macro cell design. Coming to the second example for CPLD, implement the given Boolean function using CPLD. The function is like that. F equal to x1, x3, x6 bar plus x1, x4, x5, x6 bar plus x2, x3, x7 plus x2, x4, x5, x7. This is the given function using the CPLD. Let us see the first design using this function. First, you can design the CPLD architecture. How many variables here given? X1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6 and x7. You can connect here the inverting and non-inverting gates. This is the simple, already we discussed in PIL like structure. You can design like this. This is up to here the PIL operation, same. Already we discussed it in previous session. What you have to design in PLA, PIL like structure. Here you can design the PLA structure, the AND operation side programming using this expression x1, x3, x6 bar. But this orange lines, indicates the programming operation. Black lines, it is not indicating the programming lines, right? This is the PLA like operations. Here, how many expressions given here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we are product terms 1, 2, 3, 4 product terms. This is the first product term, second product term, third product term, and fourth product term. Here also you can use the how many gates and gets 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 product terms we are using here, TOT AND gates, and this AND gate output connected to feed to the OR gate input. This OR gate PL, like this is the PL output connected to the XOR gate. Why you are connecting XOR gate means PL like block XOR gate means the XOR gate, why you are connecting means the function F directly, the function F directly you can observe the programming here, but it is not complement, that's why you can put here 0. Means 0 means it directly transfers same function, means the F function transfer to the XOR operation. If the F function complement, you can put here 1. Means the F bar, the output of the XOR gate is transferred to the complement, means F. But here the given example, only the function directly programming, that's why you can place here XOR input side programming only 0. Right? The function of the XOR output directly it can receive transfer to the F directly. But here in this condition, you can observe the F function, the selection of the max 0. The 0 selection of the max means it can goes to the combinational circuit. Means it can operate the function directly the combinational circuit. You can observe the using this tri-state buffer. You can observe the function F equal to X1, X3, X2 bar like this. This is the function. Similarly, the function, for example, you can operate this example, you can operate the sequential circuit, means the clock should be the high and the mux should be the selection line, should be the 1. It can operate using this sequential circuit D flip-flap, you can observe the flip-flap. But here in this condition, you can observe the orange line, the programming only the combinational circuit, we are showing this example. Okay, right? It is not showing sequential circuit, only we are showing here orange line, combinational circuit. If you want to the combinational circuit, means the clock should be the 1 and mux should be the 1, the operation, it is a sequential operation, right? Thank you.